Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos. So hello students, today the topic that we'll be studying, we've already completed the chapter almost, and the last topic that we remain with is the difference between the impulse turbine and hydraulic turbines. So we've already seen different types of turbines, we've seen impulse turbine, we've seen reaction turbine. Now let's see the difference between them. So this is the favorite question among the examiners. They generally put this question in the question paper. So the difference between impulse turbine and reaction turbine. So we'll make two columns and we'll write each of the difference, and I'll explain you the meaning of each of the difference. So as we know, the definition itself says that impulse turbine is a turbine in which all the velocity, all the energy of the water is converted into kinetic energy. All the head that the water has or any kind of fluid has is converted into kinetic energy, is called impulse turbine. And the reaction turbine is the one in which all the energy of water, that is all the head of water, is converted into both kinetic energy and pressure energy. So this is the main difference between them. So this would be our first point. So this is the first point, depending on the conversion, on different energy conversions. The second point is about it is not essential that the wheel should run full, since in impulse turbine there is no pressure energy involved, and in reaction turbine there is pressure energy involved. So you must have seen a reaction Pelton turbine. So in Pelton turbine, the pressure inside the turbine is always atmospheric pressure, because the whole of the energy gets converted to kinetic energy, so the pressure inside is atmospheric pressure. Whereas in reaction turbine, if you see, it's completely closed, it's completely sealed, there should not be any leakage of air inside. So you should see to it that it is always running full, there has to be no leakage of air inside or anything going out of the turbine. Hence, since here the pressure energy is also involved, the wheel should always be full of water. Otherwise, if there is empty space or lacunas, there are chances that air may get enter into the turbine, and which will lead to loss in the efficiency. So care has to be taken about that. So impulse turbine, it is not necessary that the turbine should run full, but here in this case, in reaction turbine, we should see to it that the turbine is always full of water. There has to be no gaps, there has to be no empty spaces, because that will lead to entrapment of air, and which will lead to loss in the efficiency of the turbine. So the third difference is the water flows through the nozzle. As we saw when we saw the construction of Pelton wheel, we saw that when the water comes out of the nozzle, it goes and strikes the buckets, and the buckets are two elliptical shaped construction which are mounted on the periphery of the wheel. So the buckets are fixed on the wheel, so the water comes and strikes on the bucket, and the wheel starts rotating, which in turn helps to generate power. Whereas in reaction turbine, it is not like that. The water first goes to the guide vanes, it moves over the guide vanes such that there is no friction involved, and after it goes from glides over the guide vanes, it strikes the moving vanes. So the guide vanes give them proper direction, so that the water strikes the moving blade at a proper angle, and so that we can get maximum efficiency out of the turbine. So the way in which water strikes the blade, there's a difference, because an impulse, it directly goes and strikes the fixed blades. Here there are guide vanes and there are moving vanes, so this can be the third difference between them. Now let's see the fourth difference between reaction and impulse turbine. So next difference is about work done. Work that comes out, or the energy that is generated, or the power that is developed from the turbine, is because of change in kinetic energy in case of impulse turbine. Whereas in case of reaction turbine, the work output that we get is because of change in kinetic energy and also because of change in pressure energy. So both the energies are involved here in this case to generate power. Whereas in case of impulse turbine, only one type of energy is involved to create power, that is kinetic. And in reaction, both kinetic energy and pressure energy is involved to develop power. So the next difference is, in case of impulse turbine, it is possible to regulate the flow of water without any losses. You can control the discharge rate through the nozzle, through the valve mechanism that we have, and spear valve mechanism that we have in Pelton wheel. Whereas in reaction turbine, it is not possible to regulate the flow without losses, because if you try to control the flow rate, there'll be different losses that will be happening with reaction turbine. So this is the fifth difference. Now let's see the next difference. So the next difference, you can put example of impulse is Pelton wheel, and the example of reaction turbine is Francis and Kaplan. So that was all about this topic, difference between. So we've seen five differences between the both, and we've seen examples of each of them. So that was all about the difference. I hope you've understood this topic, impulse and reaction turbine difference. Thank you.